Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will learn about Ohm's law. Mr. George Simon Ohm, a German scientist, discovered Ohm's law. The relationship between voltage, current and resistance in an electrical circuit in the year 1827. Ohm's law states that the current flowing in an electric circuit is directly proportional to the applied voltage and inversely proportional to the resistance in the circuit. Let's try to understand this definition with an example. Just imagine a dam across a river and the water flow from its floodgates. If the floodgates of the dam are kept open, the flow of water from the floodgates is directly proportional to the water level in the river. If the water level of the river is low, then the water flow from the floodgates is also low. The higher the water level of the river, the higher the flow of water from the floodgates. So, flow is directly proportional to level of the water. Consider the water level of the river as voltage in a circuit and the flow from the floodgate as current. So, from this example, we can say that the flow of current is directly proportional to the applied voltage. We can stop this water flow by closing this floodgate. If we slightly open this gate, then we will get some flow. If we open this floodgate completely, we can have more flow of water. Here, the flow of water depends upon how much this floodgate is kept open. Consider this gate as a resistance in a circuit. If the resistance is more, then the flow of current is less and vice versa. So, from this, we can say that the flow of current is inversely proportional to the resistance in the circuit. Let's observe what happens when we apply some voltage, for example, 3 volts to a conductor. We will get a uniform motion of free electrons. That is what we call current. If we double the applied voltage to 6 volts, then the rate of flow of electrons are also increases. We will get a faster flow of charged particles or higher flow of current. So, the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the voltage applied across it. We will do a small experiment with a lamp of 6 volts. If we apply 3 volts to the lamp, the lamp glows dimmer. Because of less voltage, less current flowing through the filament of the bulb, hence it glows dimmer. If we double the voltage to 6 volts, now the lamp glows brighter. Because of the higher voltage, higher the movement of electric charge or current through the filament of the bulb, hence the lamp glows brighter. If we increase the voltage to 9 volts, now the lamp is burnt out because the excess voltage creates excess current flow through the filament of the bulb, so it is unable to handle this excess flow of charged particles. Hence the bulb gets damaged. This is the reason why many electrical appliances in our home get fused when there is a power fluctuation. If we insert a resistive material or resistor between two conductors, instead of applying a high voltage of 9 volts, we get a reduced flow of current because this resistor blocks the flow of electrons. So, the higher the resistance, the lesser the flow of current. Hence, the current is inversely proportional to the resistance. So, here we have two equations. Current is directly proportional to voltage and inversely proportional to resistance. Just combine these two equations. We get current equals to voltage divided by resistance. I equals to V by R. This is how we can mathematically represent the relationship between current, voltage and resistance in any electric circuit. There is a trick to remembering Ohm's law equations. Just arrange the letters V, I and R in a triangle like this. V at the top, I in the left hand corner and R in the right hand corner. If the value of voltage is unknown, then V equals to I into R. To find current in a circuit, we use equation I equals to V by R. And for resistance, R equals to V by I. Now we will discuss Ohm's law in practical methods. Suppose 9 volts battery connected across 9 ohms resistor, then the current I that is flowing through this resistor can be determined by using Ohm's law I equals to V by R. That equals to 9 volts divided by 9 ohms, that equals to 1 amp current flowing through this 9 ohm resistor. We can measure current by connecting an ammeter in series with the circuit. Remember, we must always connect ammeter in series with the circuit. If we double the voltage to 9 plus 9 volt, that equal to 18 volts, then the current I flowing through that resistor will also doubles to 2 amperes. Here we have doubled the resistance 9 ohms plus 9 ohms, that is 18 ohms. Then the current flowing through this resistor will also reduce to 1 amp. Here is the conclusion of this experiment. First we have doubled the voltage, so the current is also gets doubled. Next we have increased the resistance, then the current is also reduced. This is what Ohm's law states. If we increase voltage in any electric circuit, the current will also increases. If we increase the resistance, then the flow of current will get reduced. When current flows through a resistance, there will be a dissipation of power from that resistance. Electrical power defined as the rate at which energy is supplied or consumed in the system per unit time. Power can be determined by using Ohm's law. As we know, power is the product of voltage and current. The power triangle can be employed to determine the values of power, voltage and current when the other two parameters are given to us. We can calculate power by using Ohm's law, that is by substituting values of V, I and R. Here according to Ohm's law, voltage V equals to I into R. So the formula of power can be rewritten as P equals to, instead of V, we write I into R multiplied by I. So our new equation is P equals to I square R. Next one, we can write this current I as V by R according to Ohm's law. So here P equal to V into V by R. Here we have replaced I with V by R. Then our new equation of power, P equals to V square divided by R. So the equations for power, P equals to VI or I square R or V square by R. To understand the relationship between voltage, current, resistance and power, to find out their values, we can use this Ohm's law pie chart. Suppose if you know the values of current and voltage of an electric circuit, then we can find out power and resistance values by using these two formulas. Like Ohm's law pie chart, we can condense Ohm's law equations into a simple matrix table for easy reference when calculating an unknown value. If we know the values of voltage and resistance, we can find the values of current and power by using these two formulas. Let's solve some examples using Ohm's law. We all use electric lamps in our home. If it is written as 220 volts and 60 watts on that bulb, then let's find out the amount of current flowing through it and the resistance of the bulb. Here, power rating of the bulb is 60 watts and voltage is 220 volts. We know power equals to V into I. So current can be expressed as P by V. Let's insert the given values. Here P is 60 watts divided by 220 volts. That equals to 0.27 amperes of current flowing through this bulb. As we know, I equals to V by R. So, resistance R can be expressed as V by I. Let's insert the voltage and current values. 220 volts divided by 0.27 amperes, that gives 815 ohms resistance of this bulb. Like this, we can find unknown values by using Ohm's law formulas. Let's solve one more example. The current flowing through an electric stove is 20 amperes and the resistance of the heating element is 11 ohms. Find out the voltage applied across it and the power consumed by the stove. Here we know that the amount of current flowing through the stove is 20 amperes and resistance of heating element is 11 ohms. According to Ohm's law, I equals to V by R. So, voltage V is I into R. Let's insert current and resistance values. 20 multiplied with 11, that gives 220 volts of voltage applied to the stove. Now, power P equals to V into I. That gives 4400 watts of power consumed by the stove. There are thousands of applications of Ohm's law in daily life, like domestic fan regulators. By moving them to and fro, we can control the speed of the fan. Here, the current flowing through the fan is controlled by regulating the resistance inside the regulator. Electric kettles, irons and heaters have resistances in them in the form of metal coils that permits a certain amount of current to flow through them to provide required heat. The amount of power to be supplied to them is calculated by using Ohm's law. Fuses and circuit breakers designed by using Ohm's law. They protect the circuit by blowing them when the flow of current is too high. The overall working of mobile and laptop chargers is also controlled by using Ohm's law. There are some limitations of Ohm's law. Ohm's law is not applicable for unilateral electric elements like diodes and transistors, as they allow flow of electric current in one direction only. Ohm's law is also not applicable for non-linear elements like thyristors, because in non-linear elements, the flow of current is not exactly proportional to the applied voltage, which means the resistance value changes for different values of voltage and current. That's all about Ohm's law. I hope in this video you have understand the relationship between various parameters, current, voltage, power and resistance. If you like this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. In my next video, we will discuss about the series and parallel combination of resistors. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.